This video covers tips for painting an interior room of your house. Make sure you watch our DIY video on preparing to paint before getting to this video. A well-prepped area is key to a successful painting job. Once you've chosen your paint and it's been mixed at the home improvement store, you will still need to give it a stir at home before you start applying it to the walls. As you stir, tilt the stick so you pull paint up from the bottom of the can as you mix it. Using a brush, start with the edges in the room. This is called cutting in. This step should be done with a high-quality paintbrush. Once you've cut in your area, you can use your roller to paint the walls. Place a plastic liner in your roller tray to save on cleanup. When pouring your paint into your roller tray, be careful not to overfill the tray. Get a couple good rolls of paint on the roller and be slow in your rolling to prevent the paint from splattering. It's suggested that you paint in the same general direction or in the shape of a W. Each coat usually needs at least 2 hours of drying time before another can be applied, but be sure to read your paint's instructions to confirm this. If you start painting but have to take a break before the final coat, then be sure to cover your roller tray and any paint cups. Also, wrap your rollers and brushes with plastic wrap or a plastic grocery bag. If you must wait longer than 24 hours before your next coat, you may need to rinse out your brushes to store them and throw away and replace any used rollers. You don't want any dry paint on them when you start back up again. After your final coat, save any unused paint by pouring it back into the can. Hammer the top of the can for a tight seal and write which room the paint was used in for future reference. Be sure to store the paint in a cool, dry place, such as a basement or closet. Once the paint in the room has completely dried, carefully remove your painter's tape to reveal a sharp edge to your trim.